All right, so here we are, inside the bloody crypt. Let's go Acid and Sonic again. Maybe I need fire as well. I like this robe, nice and colourful. Alright, we've got plenty of enemies coming. Can we fetch any more to the firewall that I've got here? I guess not. Playing a character like this, a lot of it is about optimizing your use of firewall. Ouch. That's why you don't like crits on this type of character. Oh, it's a champion. I think I'm confusing my skeleton by moving around the focus of my attacks so much. Nice move by the spellcaster there. He used a fireball to break my web. Yeah, P-Hands, I think there's like a couple of completely different ways to play DDO. There's the people that are mostly playing the high-level content, and then there's the people like me that are mostly doing the low-level quests. Like, I really enjoy kind of going through the whole game, playing every quest, so I always start at level 1. But I guess that's part of playing permadeath as well, is like starting at level 1 and seeing if you survive all the way to 20. And then there's the people that are kind of racing to the epic content as fast as they can, which is a whole other game. Like, I've hardly raided at all in this game. So there's a lot of cool content I haven't really seen, but I see more of the low-level stuff. It's kind of strange, I've played this game for so many years, and I've only seen about 2 raids. Or, I guess 3 raids. Maybe my skeleton's not better at bottlenecking in doorways. He's doing okay here though. See, that's really what I want. I want him to poly aggro like that and just do all the work for me. She was smart enough to go for the caster first, though. Enough enemies here, it is well worth the firewall, I think. I thought there were a few more in that passage, maybe not. Alright, they cleared up that group. Normally I would go south first on both of these sides, so you get the shrine later. But I think I'll go north because I'm worried about just running out of spell points. Clear the shrine first and I'll just have a bit more running to do. I've done the trades. Have I done? We did the raid in Sands, which I can't even remember the name of now. Demon Queen, is it? Which was a wipe. About I think we lost 9 permadeath characters that day. And we did the shroud and the raid in the Restless Isles. But the guild doesn't do raids very often. It's the guild's not all that large, so it's hard to get a group of PD players together, all flagged for raids, especially at higher levels. Okay, looks like we're going in here. What is my... there he is. I wonder where my skeleton was going for a minute there. Nice. Always nice when you get the trip. That firewall is almost unreasonably powerful. Certainly at these levels. I don't know how many people Extreme Explorers has these days. Probably has like 10 to 20 active people. I think I'm the only person in Europe in the guild, so like at this time of day I'm almost the only person on. Or usually the only person on, which is one reason I do these solo runs, of course. But I don't get to see a lot of people in the guild, or see them very rarely. It's mostly just a few people like me in Europe, and a few other people that keep odd hours that I actually play with. Okay, one of the casters is a champion in there. But he hasn't seen us yet. Hopefully it stays that way. Another champion caster. Ouch. Ouch. Really don't like tangling with the champion spellcasters at all, but it's hard to avoid. Whoa, got surrounded by those. Right, here's the lever to open the first of the 4 locks. No, champion spellcaster. I like it when we get stone guard champions though, as my shocking grasp does double damage to them. Breaking all the breakables as I go through here, because this quest is worth a lot of XP and it's worth even more with the bonuses. So if I can get the breakables bonus, that's a significant amount of extra. We're worth like 1,000 XP for getting the breakables. Can we pick off this champion from the back? Yes. Well, until those guys got in the way. Uh-oh. I think they both walked into the firewall. Ouch. Okay, that went okay. Having the getting cursed is kind of bad at low levels. It really lowers your saves quite a lot. Is it only minus two? Minus two is not so bad. But it's very bad in the kobold quest because lightning bolts are really the main weapon the kobolds have, and anything that lowers your dex save is a big problem. It's less of a deal with the casters in here since they tend to do more stuff like Scorching Ray. Alright, one quadrant cleared. Think I'll clear the shrine while I'm here. I might even use it. I'm pretty low on spell points. Hey, I missed the chest. Yeah, we're running low on spell points. I went the wrong way. So I think I will use the shrine, then I'll try and do the next two without shrining. A skeleton did his job on Pellagra. Oh, the named is here. Where is he? I didn't see him. I mean, he must be here. The chest is here. Oh shit. Alright, we got him in the web. Nice, we get two chests for one boss. Yeah, I'll definitely shrine here. Pull my Corphos trinket here so I can do a few more buffs on my skeleton. So there are two other shrines in the quest. So I'm playing hard so I can only use each shrine once. I should have plenty. I'm doing okay here for spell points. And I'm not even having to be all that careful with spell points, really. Throw some of my own buffs. Right. At least I'm not in here. On Elite in here, I have trouble getting level drained by the undead, but they don't hit very often with level drain on hard. I think they can hit you with it occasionally, but on Elite they use it quite often. Okay, next quadrant. It's nice the skeleton does at least follow my focus with his attacks. But it's actually the easiest way to direct him, providing I don't mind mixing it up a bit myself. Okay, there is a champion caster coming. Oh, I think he's in the alcove. Oop. Champion throwing fireballs around. Another champion here. It's a bit messy, but we're okay. White's dead, now the champion. I'm trying to stay out of his sight so he can't hit me. Good work. No mysterious though. Nice. Always fun when you can land the trip. Letting my skeleton do his job. It's nice when he bottlenecks them like this. Okay, let's go for the switch, then we get this whole area opened up. Right, this is messy. And my health's not good. Let's just back out and let them sort it out amongst themselves for a bit, I think. Great, he's all through the firewall. That's good. Alright, my skeleton's got it in hand. The last time I played a solo PAL master run, the fight I eventually died in, I died and then the skeleton cleaned up. So it can definitely happen that the skeleton just tanks it out while you die yourself. It's actually on my, was my second permadeath run I put on YouTube, so that grisly fight is recorded for all time. So the furthest I got in any of my permadeath runs that I recorded, I made it all the way to level 13, I think. I've made it to 20 on a solo once, but that wasn't on the recording. Is there another spellcaster in this group? So we've seen all the Burning Heart clerics. It's usually a white caster as well, maybe not in this group. Alright, 2 of 4 locks opened. We just finished smashing everything here. So that's this whole half of the level cleared, and now we go over to the other half. My spell points are pretty good, actually. I'm doing alright. I should make it through to the next shrine with no trouble. Okay, over to the east side. And there's somebody out there. I wonder if there would be. Yeah, well, wherever he was from, he snapped back. Still definitely looking for good caster implements for this character. Haven't really found many good ones so far. I think I'm carrying something to boost my electric damage at the moment. So I should be boosting my fire damage maybe at this stage. Although I'm pretty much doing as much damage as I need to with the firewall right now. We go north first because I want the shrine after this next part. A champion caster. Skyborn too, it's not good news. Alright, my skeleton's taking him on. Whoa. Getting value out of this firewall. Ouch, what hit me? Oh, there's still one back here. This might be another room full of stuff, maybe? Okay, maybe not. Around the corner here, there certainly is. Let's actually run around the corner and start a big fire. Okay, we've got one champion in there. Alright, pulling some more. One of the dangers of having firewalls, it does encourage you to play very aggressively and pull lots of enemies into the spell you've already cast. Try and get most value from it. And that worked pretty well there. Still quite a few of these guys though. We are up to 152 undead slain so far in this quest. Well, undead and the priests, I guess. Champion caster. Damn, I think he debuffed half my resists. And just healed himself. Okay, what do we got? We need acid. So we put Sonic back on as well. Okay, that cost me some spell points there. Let's use my Corvus trinket as well to get some points back. Getting a lot of champion spellcasters in here, considering I'm only on hard. Wasn't expecting quite so many. Ouch. My skeleton took quite a bit of harm there, actually. I don't think he needs healing yet, though. Ah, okay, it's down here we're going to. There's another priest down there. That's getting some value from the firewall. Is this guy immune to the fire or something? Why is he so undamaged? Well, that was a little messy, but we got it done. I am real short of spell points, though. I guess this is the place I kind of expect to be short of spell points in this one. Alright, 3 of 4 sections completed. Time to go to the shrine. No chests, so I don't think we have any names down here. Ouch. Dragging these guys back and forward through the firewall here. Alright, here we are. Not enough points to actually heal my skeleton here. I guess I can make him shrine though. Okay, just one quadrant to do and then the boss fight. There's no buffing before his shrine. That was foolish. Doesn't matter too much though. Okay, there's the priest. Two champions. Okay, a bit messy, but it worked out. You didn't have a champion. We finally got to the aggression bonus with almost 200 enemies killed. These goggles are actually an upgrade. Not that it's a lot of use to me having the doing melee damage, but it is an upgrade, so I will take it. Oh, that's handy actually. Potion of blindness removal. I think the boss in here can cast blindness, so I might even need that. Okay, my skeleton's in pretty bad shape now. Yeah, let's heal the skeleton up. That's an even better upgrade, though. Plus intelligence is just what I need. That gets my intelligence up to 28 at level 7. It's not too bad. Well, so I'm now walking around an undead tomb with a death aura on, which is not a great plan. Okay. Okay, we're doing fine. We got plenty of spell points at this point. All right, lock number four opened. Let's go hit it. Ooh, nice hold. That was a nice play. If they'd had a champion in that fight, they might have got me in trouble. Firewall and web come to the rescue. Alright, that's all four quadrants cleared and the way to the boss is open. Just gotta run back to the center where the boss is. Alright, you can get attacked on your way to the shrine here. Like there can be enemies actually in the entrance that come out immediately. Maybe that's even a good thing though. Pull some of the enemies that are just in the entrance here. Don't really wanna wake up the boss though. I'll try shrining, see what happens. Alright, I think the buffs here will be the same, Sonic and Fire. Acid in case any champions show up. And all my other goodies. The plan here is to kill the first wave and then I'll run around while the skeleton keeps everybody busy. Gotta find gotta find Solace's hub before we can attack him. So let's start running around. Alright, he's active. Oh hey, he's here. Or somewhere around here. Okay, there it is. Now we can fight him. He doesn't just run away from us. All right, all we got to do now is keep everything on fire. We did it. Potion of Blood, that sounds like a pleasant item. Not relevant to me anyway. Clear out a bit of inventory space so I can take the book. How do we do? We got Onslaught, we got Ransack. Yeah. Pretty nice. 13,000 XP for a level 6 quest. It's not bad at all. I didn't remember to pick up my Silver Flame trinket, but it doesn't really matter. I'm not going to wear a Silver Flame item on a Necromancer. So, yeah. That's the quest done. Yeah, I got freed up one pretty safely. Actually, it was scarier probably in the previous quest where there were more spellcasters really hitting me, but my skeleton was really doing his job in this one. I guess there's a lot of doorways, a lot of fights occurring in doorways in this one, so the skeleton was able to bottleneck them a bit. There were a lot of champion spellcasters in this one, though. Usually I get pretty worried by other champion casters. They do sometimes throw out some really high damage numbers. But this quest at least gives you plenty of corners you can back around. So I was very often there backing away from enemies, just putting a corner between me and them and letting the skeleton do his work. Having the summons to that is tough enough to actually go and fight even the champion casters is really big. Alright, I'm going to break here. That's enough for one session. Just picking up my end reward. Doesn't look like there's anything too exciting here. I've already got con plus 4, so I didn't really need that. Is spell sight plus 5? I've already got spell sight plus 5. Okay. Yeah, it's nothing there exciting, really. Alright, that's it for this session. Thank you for watching.